AI can save you time. Yes, you have heard me say it before, but you might be wondering, okay, Alex, how exactly can I use AI to streamline my creative marketing process? It is hard to streamline creativity. I get it, and in this video, I'm gonna show you three very specific AI prompts that you can use to massively cut down on the most time-consuming part of marketing. Yes, I am talking about market research. Keep watching. Hey Posse, what's up? It's Alex coming at you this week with a topic that is highly relevant to every single copywriter, business owner, or marketer out there watching this right now, because no matter what you sell or are thinking about selling on the internet or anywhere else for that matter, market research is absolutely the very first step. Well, that is assuming you want to actually help people and make money doing it, which I'm hoping is you. So if that's you, then make sure to subscribe to my channel below. Every single week, well, almost every single week, I share marketing, copywriting, and branding tips to help you make an impact online today. And while you're at it, don't forget to hit that bell icon to be notified when my next video goes live. Now, everyone knows that market research is probably the most time-consuming part of marketing. And that's because it is so very important to get right from the get-go. It takes time to make sure you're speaking to the right people and correctly communicating to their real fears, desires, and challenges. But thanks to AI, this whole process just got a lot quicker. But before I dive in, I have one big, fat disclaimer to share with all of you. Please, guys, please, please, please remember that AI is a tool to help you do creative work faster. It should not be treated as a replacement for critical thinking and problem solving. Let me say that again. It should not be treated as a replacement for critical thinking or problem solving. What many people don't realize is that lots of free tools like ChatGPT are not actually connected to the internet by default, as it says right here in OpenAI's Help Center, and therefore can produce incorrect, inaccurate, or even harmful results. Yep, newsflash guys, AI can straight up make stuff up. Now, this is actually known as an AI hallucination. As reported in the New York Times, AI relies on a complex algorithm that analyzes the way humans put words together on the internet. It does not decide what is true and what is not. The tech industry often refers to these inaccuracies as hallucinations. But to some researchers, hallucinations is too much of a euphemism. Even researchers within tech companies worry that people will rely too heavily on these systems for medical and legal advice and other information they use to make daily decisions. ChatGPT also added a disclaimer right here under the prompt field too that says ChatGPT may produce inaccurate information about people, places, and facts. So basically everything. But the good news is, earlier this year, ChatGPT said they will be rolling out web browsing features to its paid ChatGPT Plus users, including over 70 web-enabled plugins. But even if you have a paid account, that doesn't mean that it's web-enabled by default. Ask me how I know? Well, I actually have a paid ChatGPT account, and I asked it if it was connected to the internet, and well, ChatGPT said no. Web browsing is actually a beta feature that you have to manually turn on under your account settings. Easy enough, right? Well, not exactly, because I checked in my account settings and I do not have that beta feature available despite having a paid plus account. So it appears that not all users have access to this yet, which is why you should never, ever, ever rely solely on AI to tell you what's accurate, relevant, or actually happening in the minds of your customers or the market today. Instead, what you should be using AI for is to help you with the brainstorming process. And that's actually really good news for you, because let's be honest, that is the hard part. Trying to decide exactly what your customer cares about most, what you can say that will speak most directly to them, and more importantly, how you can say it in a way that will be receptive to them actually hearing it. And that is what this video is about. In this video, I'm gonna share my screen with you and walk you through the exact three prompts that I use with ChatGPT to quickly create an ideal buyer persona that is pretty detailed and specific. Now, for the best results, I suggest using all three of these prompts together, because where I see a lot of people going wrong with AI is that they just use a random prompt here or a random prompt there. here a prompt, there a prompt, everywhere a prompt, prompt, getting results that are really flat and honestly just straight up unusable, at least from my perspective. And that's because ChatGPT and other AI content generating tools get better and more specific with every single prompt and interaction you create within that same chat thread. So this three prompt sequence will help you write emotionally charged, rich source copy that speaks directly to your customers' fears and dreams and aspirations and frustrations. And shout out to my rainmaker, Lindsay, who joined me for an awesome AI copywriting workshop for members of my Launch Files copywriter training program, where we go way deeper into how we use AI for market research and producing really juicy source copy. You can get your hands on this exclusive AI workshop series when you join the Launch Files program at the link in the description box below. But here are three prompts that you can use to get started right now. Prompt number one, who is your ideal customer? Okay, obviously a really important step in market research for any product or service is to first know who the heck you are selling to. That is why creating a customer avatar is so important before, yes, I said before you start using AI. Your customer avatar is a fictitious character who represents your ideal customer. This is one person with a clear set of desires, fears, pains, and dreams. And the clearer and more specific you can be about who this person is, the more effective your marketing and messaging will be, and the more effective your AI prompt is gonna be because you're gonna get better, more accurate output. So let me show you what I mean. Here's prompt number one. Today, you're a world-class copywriter performing market research to better understand your audience. I want you to create an ideal buyer persona for product/service. The typical buyer is usually customer avatar description. Include demographics, psychographics, main challenges, values, and motivations of this buyer persona. Include key emotional drivers and powerful language. Give the persona a real name so it's easy for us to refer to it going forward. All right, so you can see that I put that first prompt into ChatGPT here, and I made sure to fill out the information. So I want you to create the ideal buyer persona profile for a luxury dog grooming and boarding service. The typical buyer is usually a high-achieving woman who works a demanding job that has her away from home for long hours. She has no children of her own and gives all of that time, attention, and care to her dog. She wants the best treatment for her dog and is willing to pay a premium price for quality care, safe products, and lots of one-on-one trainer time. So that is the information that I have plugged in. And you can see here that it put out a buyer persona profile for dog lover Laura. I love that they put in the word luxury there. Luxury dog lover Laura. Demographics. Okay, we got Laura, 35 to 50, female, single, high achieving professional with a demanding job. Great, that's basically what I said. Here's where things start to get a little bit more interesting. Psychographics, lifestyle, passions, social circles. She's tech savvy. She values quality, willing to pay a premium for products. This is all kind of really interesting. Again, close to what I had put in. Here's where it gets interesting, right? Main challenges, balancing a demanding job, finding reliable, safe, and high quality products, ensuring her dog remains well-trained and happy despite her working long hours, her values, unconditional love, motivations, emotional drivers. This is interesting, right? Love and guilt. Interesting. You know, guilt, I think, is definitely an emotion she's probably feeling, but notice that I didn't put that anywhere in the description. But again, super interesting here. Pride, happiness. Here's some powerful language, right, that can be used. Laura prioritizes her dog's well-being above all else. It's not just about grooming, it's about pampering and nurturing her furry family member. She demands excellent in every aspect of her dog's life. A sanctuary. Ooh, I like that word. A sanctuary. Quality is her mantra. Awesome. So really great buyer persona for that first prompt. Okay, so notice that when I put that prompt in, I gave ChatGPT quite a bit of detail about the customer avatar. Yes, I had to do some work first to identify this person, and this is key to getting great results with AI. If I had put in something super generic, my results would not have been that good. Remember, with AI, your output is only as good as your input, so it takes a little bit of time to get the input right. And to help you make the most of this prompt, grab my free customer avatar worksheet in the description box below. All right, moving on to prompt number two. How is your ideal customer feeling? Okay, so this is where things start to get really juicy because now we're moving away from who your customer is as a person to what they might be feeling right now about their current situation and why they are here learning from you or about to buy your product or service. Now, this is huge because remember, people buy emotionally and justify logically. So listing off a bunch of facts about your dog boarding service, albeit important information to share, is not gonna be what gets your customers to buy from you. Relating to your customer and demonstrating that you actually get what they're experiencing is what builds trust and gets them invested in what you have to say and what you have to offer. All right, so let me show you prompt number two. Great job. Now tell me 5 believable challenges and 5 deepest fears customer name has around finding the perfect product or service. And what will happen if he, she, they doesn't address the problem? I don't want boring surface level answers. Give me the deepest fears that customer name likely would not admit out loud unless nobody was listening. What is he, she, they afraid of the most? What causes him, her, them discomfort? What causes him, her, them pain and anxiety? What does he, she, they worry about? What keeps him, her, them up at night? All right, so right here in the same chat, below the first prompt, I'm putting in the second prompt here. Great job, tell me 5 believable challenges that Laura has around finding the perfect pet grooming and boarding service for her dog. So you can see I filled in the prompt, fill in the blank there. Now here's where we start to get really into it, right? Fear of neglect. She's afraid of neglecting her dog's emotional needs, health and safety concerns. She's worried about subpar grooming and a boarding facility. Exposed to diseases, injuries, and neglect. Oh my gosh, right? I mean, I'm a pet owner and I'm already like, no, tater. trust issues, behavioral regression. This is interesting and something I might not have thought of. You know, trust, I mean, that's kind of obvious, right? Like, yeah, I really want to make sure I trust the people who are watching Tater. I'm going to use my dog because, you know, I'm not Laura, but still. Laura's anxious that her dog's behavior may regress. I think that's like a real fear that people have when they have, you know, a trained dog, that if they're around other not very well trained dogs, what's gonna happen? Feeling replaceable, that's interesting. Worries that her dog might become more attached to the caregivers. We're feeling replaced, I mean, that was not even on my mind, but now it is, right? So again, really, really interesting things that you might not have thought of when coming up with some of those, challenges and fears that Laura is experiencing. Okay, so obviously knowing these fears and concerns is gonna be super valuable when you're positioning your product or service. But what's even more important than knowing what the fears and concerns are is knowing how to communicate them in a way that makes your customer think, oh my God, that's exactly how I feel. And that's where this last prompt is going to come in handy. Prompt number 3, how does your ideal customer think and talk? It is so, so important to communicate to your customer in the way they speak, think, and feel. As much as possible, you want to use the thoughts and phrases that they actually think and say in their day-to-day life when they're talking with their friends. You want them to read what you wrote and literally think that you just wrote it for them. So how do you get inside the head of your customer like that? Well, that brings me to my final prompt. Thank you. Keeping all of these challenges and fears in mind, write a 700-word journal entry from the perspective of customer name. All right, now right here in the same chat, I am putting in my third prompt. Thank you. Keeping all of those challenges and fears in mind, write a 700-word journal entry from the perspective of Laura. Okay, date, September 10th, 2023. Dear journal, tonight I find myself in a contemplative mood, sitting by the window with a cup of chamomile tea as the gentle rain outside matches the turbulent storm of emotions inside me. Okay, so it's like a little bit over the top, a little bit dramatic, but what's really great about this is that it's taking those fears and challenges that we identified in prompt 2 and it's putting them into language that is first person for your customer, which might give you some ideas that you can pull into your copy to make it more relatable. Right? So, you know, you're the one that greets me at the door, your tail is wagging as if I were the most important person in the world. I think everyone can agree, you know, who has a dog, that that's how you feel when your dog comes home, right? So love that. Max, it's not just about being away for long hours, it's the guilt that gnaws at me. That's such a powerful, you know, powerful, visceral descriptor of the guilt that she's feeling. The fear that you might feel unloved or lonely when I'm not here. I know you're strong and resilient, but that doesn't stop my heart from aching at the thought of you feeling abandoned. Again, right? Little over the top, but really great to get inside the mind of your customers. Okay, so you can see how powerful these phrases are. They're emotional and descriptive. And this is really, really great source copy. Now, of course, you wouldn't necessarily take and use any of this word for word because let's be honest, it's a little bit dramatic and kind of over the top and who really talks like that? But now you have a ton of inspiration of how this customer may be feeling and you can specifically touch on their biggest hopes and fears in your copy. And now that you have all of this juicy source copy, it's time to use your human creative genius to take everything over the finish line. You want to use proven formulas and copywriting principles to translate this output into usable, persuasive, and powerful copy and marketing assets like emails, ads, landing pages, and sales pages. And this is exactly what I help you do inside my 8-week copywriting training program, the Copy Posse Launch Files. When you join the Launch Files program at the link below, you'll also get your hands on an exclusive AI workshop series with me and members of my high-level program, Rain. During these video sessions, you'll learn the Copy Posse's personal techniques, prompts, and tips on how to create specific, relatable, and relevant copy using the foundational Launch Files formulas in combination with AI. Because remember, when it comes to leveraging these emerging tools, your output is only as good as your input, and a shortcut only works if you know where in the hell you're going. By following proven formulas and timeless strategies, you'll be able to more effectively utilize AI, streamline your copywriting process, and produce output that actually makes sense and speaks to your audience. In each video workshop, you'll get a real-time preview of how we use AI to create an accurate customer profile, generate attention-grabbing hooks, and produce powerful, benefit-rich source copy in way less time. And you'll learn all about that program in the description box below. All right, guys, that's all I have for you today. Give me a thumbs up below if you found this helpful, and let me know in the comments what you'd love to learn about next. I will be back next week with a brand new video. Until then, I'm Alex. Ciao for now. All right, guys, if you enjoyed that video, make sure to check out the next one from me right here. And you can click right here to get a free gift. When it comes to leveling up your content creation, the name of the game is work smarter, not harder. In this tutorial, I'm gonna show you 19 ways you can easily repurpose one piece of content, so you can squeeze the most value out of your content marketing strategy, maximize your visibility, and reach as many people as possible without adding any extra stress, time, or energy. Stick around.